Hello, my name is Katya. I'm an ichthyologist and hydrobiologist at 𝗪𝗵𝗮𝘁 Labs. In this video, I will demonstrate how to perform a skin scraping and gill biopsy on large aquarium or pond fish. Sometimes it is necessary to examine the skin and gills of fish for microscopic parasites. For pond fish or large aquarium fish, we can perform a skin scraping and gill biopsy using a slide to create a sample for microscopic examination. To perform a skin scrape, you will need the following tools and objects. Two buckets or containers with a lid to temporarily hold the fish, one for sedation and one for recovery. A fish net, standard-sized microscope slides, cover glasses, sedative if possible, a pipette or syringe, gloves, tweezers, paper tissue, and a well-lit workstation. Use a bucket or container suitable for the size of the fish. Rinse the recovery bucket with water and fill it with enough water to cover the fish. Also, rinse the sedation bucket with water and fill it with enough water to cover the fish. Use a convenient amount for sedation, such as 5 liters. Add the sedative and stir properly to dissolve, following the product instructions. At the end of the video, I will show you what to do if sedation is not possible. Catch the fish with a net and place it in the prepared sedation bucket. The fish may be agitated for the first few minutes, so cover the bucket to prevent the fish from jumping out. Don't rush and wait until the fish is calm before performing the skin scrape, as it will be easier to handle the fish. Carefully take the fish out and position it so that you can scrape it in the direction from head to tail. Hold the slide at a 45-degree angle and gently, without pressing hard, scrape along the lateral line and then along the base of the dorsal fin. A sample of slime and perhaps a few scales will be left on the glass. Carefully set the slide aside and take a new slide for the gill biopsy if you also want to examine the gills. Hold the fish in one hand and gently open the gill cover with your finger or with your other hand. Insert the slide into the gill area, holding it parallel to the gill cover. Then carefully scoop out a small sample by scraping over the gill tissue. You may see a little bit of blood in the sample, which is normal because the blood vessels are on the surface of the gills and may be slightly damaged. This bleeding stops quickly and the fish will recover rapidly from this small injury. To regain consciousness, release the fish into the recovery bucket with aquarium or pond water and put a lid on it. Now, using a cover glass, move the sample to the middle of the slide. If there is not enough liquid, use a pipette to put a drop of water onto the middle of the slide. And lower the cover glass. Press gently with the tweezers to distribute the smear between the cover glass and the slide. The specimen is now ready for microscopic examination. It is important to examine the slides within 5 minutes after the scraping, because we are trying to find parasites that move, and some parasites will stop moving after about 5 minutes. If you prefer, you can also place the fish on a wet towel instead of holding it in your hand during the procedure. To do this, simply soak a towel in pond or aquarium water and place it on a flat surface, such as a table. If sedation is not available, you can use the wet towel to calm and restrain the fish while performing the skin scraping. However, it is important to note that a gill biopsy should not be done without sedation. Another way to perform a skin scrape without sedation is to keep the fish in the bucket and wait until it calms down. Position the fish from left to right and gently cover its eyes and head with your left hand. Lean the fish against the side of the bucket with both hands and lift it partly out of the water. With your right hand, make the scrape. In the next video, we will discuss the different types of parasites that can be found on fish and how to identify them. Make sure to turn on notifications so you don't miss it.
Remember to always follow proper procedures and use the necessary tools to keep the fish safe during the examination. If you have any questions or remarks, please leave them in the comments section below, and we will be happy to answer them. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel for more informative videos on fish health and care.